Jack Lummus's entire Giants career consisted of 9 games in 1941. On January 30, 1942, with the U.S. fully engaged in World War II, he gave up his football career to enlist in the Marine Corps and rose to become a company commander. On the morning of February 19, 1945, he landed on Iwo Jima in the first wave of assault troops. The Battle of Iwo Jima was one of the most savage in the history of the Marine Corps. After twice being knocked over by grenade blasts, Lummus continued to lead his men in combat and then stepped forward on a landmine, ripping both his legs off, but proceeded to pull himself up, courageously still giving orders to his troops. Lummus died that day on Iwo Jima, and his last words to the attending medic was, "I guess the New York Giants have lost the services of a damn good end." After his death, Lummus was awarded the Congressional Medal of Honor, one of 2 NFL players ever to be bestowed that distinction. Jack Lummus, a true American hero. Al Blozis was drafted by the Giants in the 5th round of the 1942 NFL Draft. A local boy from Garfield, New Jersey, Blozis attended William Dickinson High School in nearby Jersey City. He would excel as a multi-sport athlete at Georgetown University, starring in football and as a shot put world champion. Standing 6'6", Big Al weighed 250 pounds, and he would make an immediate impact at the position of offensive tackle for the Giants. He was an All-Star in 1942 and an All-Pro selection in 1943. But after playing in the 1944 NFL Championship game versus the Packers, Al was sent overseas to serve in World War II as a lieutenant in the Army. Tragically, Blozis was killed in action just 6 weeks later. Al was named to the 1940s NFL All-Decade Team, and his number 32 jersey is retired by the Giants. Al Blozis, a true New York Giant and an American hero.
Hey Giants fans, Saquon Barkley here. You want to see more videos? Subscribe below.